Hey guys, this is Denise Sidereta with Sassy Crafty Creations, and in the last video we finished building up the pages for the album. Now it's time to start working on the covers. We're using the Genevieve Designs. We're using her Remnants Lovely Layers printable templates. Today we are going to be using page number 15 and page number, I believe it's number 2. Yes, page number 2. Okay? I did decide that I was going to go ahead and use the hook and eye closure. And guys, my hands aren't dirty. I was making toothpaste for my son with the activated charcoal. And yeah, it's hard to get rid of the activated charcoal once it's on you. So, but this is the closure that I wanted to create. I know I've got a lot of seam binding on here, but I wanna make sure I have plenty of room. The seam binding I'm using is the Hug Snug seam binding. It's really, really good. I got this off of Etsy, and her prices are very reasonable. It's 100 yards, and very fast shipping. I think I had it within like 3 or 4 days from the day that I ordered it. So very fast shipping, very nice. And this is my closure is gonna be. I did decide to go ahead and do the soft spine, so I'm going to recycle some Tyvek that I have. I am recycling some chipboard that came in a bag that my sister gave me. This is page 2, and this is going to be for the top of the cover and for the mitering the edges. Let's move that out of the way. First, what we're going to do is adhere the boards onto page number 2. I have already marked this with score tape, and now I'm just going to add a little bit Beacon's FabriTac. Oops. Where's my, there we go. When I cut my chipboard, all I did was trace the template onto the chipboard, and I used my cutting knife to cut the board down to size. I cannot get that to let up. There we go. If I can do this without making a mess. There we go. Not bad. Not bad at all. Just burnish this down really, really good. Okay, let's see if I can do it a second time. I love FabriTac. I hope y'all had a good day. We are actually having a storm right now. You may hear some of the thundering and lightning that's going on. So if y'all do, I apologize, but you know, Mother Nature is Mother Nature and she's gonna do what she wants to do. And I need to get this cover done. I procrastinated and procrastinated enough because I wasn't sure what I wanted to do. I was like, you know what? We're just gonna do it. And so here we are. This is just some lightweight chipboard. My sister bought me a beautiful bag that was at CVS and I fell in love with it. And I figured what a great way for me to be able to upcycle that board is by putting it in this album. Did I get it on good? Oh, I have a little overage. So the spine's good. Just had that slight little overage right there. Okay. Let's see. How do I want to do this? We are going to grab the handy dandy score tape. What am I doing, Denise? Just putting it slightly off of that score line. I think I'm going to add one more in the center. Sorry guys, if my big head's in the way, I've got to make sure I don't get that on that score line. And then we'll put it right here. Another one right here. I really don't want this Tyvek to come off. Tyvek is very, very strong and it will work well to support a soft spine for this album because it's a 1 year album, so it's not going to, you know, hold as much as what a regular baby album will. Let's burnish this down. Over. Okay. there. There. Put it right up to that one mark. Because I don't want to get this in the in that score line. Those down. These off. I'm so excited about going to church tomorrow. I have been out at the flea market trying to sell some soaps the last several weeks, and I have not had any Jesus time. And I need some Jesus. That's all I can say is I need some Jesus time. I'm looking forward to going to Mass tomorrow. And then soon it will be time to have the baby shower. So I've got to like really get on the ball with this. I think I'm gonna put this in down here. You burnish that super good. What is that, Denise? I left one of those on there. I'm showing my smarts today. Okay. Make sure. Okay. I need my cutter bees for this. Okay. Now we're just going to repeat on this side. I do like to put two pieces of tie back on a soft spine. I just think it gives it that little extra. That little extra need that I think that, I mean, you could use one. I just don't want anything at all to happen to this album. So, I'm just putting it along that score mark. One more for good measure. Then one more down the middle. Excuse me. I don't know if y'all heard that or not, but I was hoping it was a quiet hiccup. I think I'm gonna need some water. Tell you what, this tape kicks some butt. Tell you what, if this Tyvek does not stick after all this tape, there's something wrong. Okay. So we're going to sure that is down really good. Turn it over, grab my cutter piece, and trim off any excess. I'm trying hard not to cut this chipboard because this chipboard is lightweight, and I'm almost certain my Tim Holtz would cut it with no problem, but I was hoping my cutter bees would be easy enough to work with and not get to where it will cut it up. Out of the way. Next, we are going to. This is what the front is going to have. And it's going to cover. So I need to put this on here. I thought I had marks for it. I guess I don't. Okay. I think that looks about even. So this is going to be covered up, but I cannot stand that. Sorry, I'm a little OCD sometimes, guys. Now my question is, do I want to fabric tag or score tape? I picked up the score tape, so I'm assuming I'm wanting score tape. What I can do is roll it up, put it on the outside, Sorry guys, I'm concentrating. You can probably smell the smoke from where you're at. Okay. Grab some fiber tape. I just refilled this bottle the other day, so it's pretty thick. It's taking a bit for that bubble to get up there. Lid on it. Now we're going to remove all this tape. I actually need I'll just go ahead and start here. Well, that sure as heck didn't work. I hope that did not mess up my miter. All right. Start breaking this down a little bit. Awesome. Alrighty. Mm-hmm. We got the cover done, except for I need to line this piece right here with a piece of cardstock and then start mitering these edges so that way I can start putting the mats for this. And I will also be adding, I probably better do this now, shouldn't I? Figure out where I want to mark for the, which way do I want this to go? I want this to go this way. Okay. I need to go ahead and mark for putting this metal piece on. So let's see. This is 6.5, so that is 3.25. Where is my pencil? Aha, there we go. So it's going to be 3.25 is the middle. And this piece is... right there. Okay. And to hold this down, I'm going to put some glossy accent. I want to put plenty of it on there. I'm going to let that dry. Maybe add a little extra right there. Right there. I think I need some new glossy accent. I need to do is get some more glossy, but I think that's gonna hold. If that does not hold, we'll find out. All right, guys, so far I've got the cover made, except for just adding the piece of cardstock to the back, and then we are going to start the matting. So I hope you enjoy this video. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe if you're new to my channel. I would greatly appreciate it. And God bless.